Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen, and today I'm going to show you guys how to create a workflow from scratch, including how to do email and text with a positive intent reply. So let's get started. So for those of you guys who don't know, we actually have a free Facebook group called Marketing Agency Automation Secrets, where we give away hundreds of dollars in free trainings every single week to our members. So click the link below to go check that out. The first thing I'm gonna do is go into High Level and click on Workflows. Now, I'm gonna click Create Workflow. I have other videos on how to import a workflow from a campaign. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do one from scratch. And I'm going to click on Start from Scratch and then click Create New Workflow. Okay, now the first thing that I want you guys to keep in mind here is not to get overwhelmed, because workflows are simply triggers turned on their side. Okay, so before, where you had the trigger on the left and you had the actions on the right, now you're going to have the trigger on the top and the actions on the bottom. Not a big deal, okay? In fact, you can actually have multiple triggers for the same actions, which is really, really cool. So this workflow is going to be pretty simple. And what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to do a blast to my list because I'm doing a giveaway. So what I want to do here for the trigger, actually, I don't need a trigger for this because I am going to add them into a workflow from the bulk actions. Now, what I could do is I could say that I'm going to do a tag here, and then I could add a tag, which would automatically put everyone in the workflow. But technically, I don't need to do that. You can if you want, but it's just extra work, okay? But here's where you're going to put the trigger. Okay, so you can trigger on contact tag, you can trigger when an appointment is created, you can trigger on when a form is submitted, you can do all this other kind of stuff. And I do have other videos on how to do this, okay? So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna add my first action, and it's going to be an email, okay? So here, I'm going to do, I actually have my copy over here, so I'm just going to paste it. And then I'm going to do like the party emoji. Okay. Now here, I'm going to take my copy here. So I'm doing a giveaway to thank all my affiliates for supporting me in my journey and helping me get to 75 agency pro accounts, which is cool. Okay, so I just pasted the email in here, and here's the link, like that. So this is a simple email that's going out. And then I'm going to click on save. Now, if you want to test it, you can put your email in here and see what it looks like. And I don't know if you noticed this, but I didn't put my from name and from email in here anymore. Why? Well, because I can actually set it here on the main workflow level here. So now I don't have to put it in each email anymore, which is really cool. Okay, so keep in mind I haven't saved yet, so make sure you save often. That way you don't lose anything. Okay, so then I'm also going to do a text. And it's going to have to be shorter, right? So here, I'm going to be like, hey, name, contact first name. It's Christine Seal. here, this is a new number, so make sure to save it. I'm gonna add that later. I'm doing a giveaway to say thank you
You have a chance to win AirPods Pro or a Yeti mic. Want the link to enter? Okay. And then here's something cool that you can do, which I'm going to do later, is I'm going to add like a contact card, which I've done before. So I actually have a new phone number because I'm in the high-level beta program for texting, which is cool. So there's the text. And then you notice I didn't put the link in here. Okay, that's because I'm going to wait till they reply. Now the hard part, right? Everyone's scared of this, but it's not that hard. So I need to wait for a reply. So I always forget to do that when I'm doing this. I don't know why. Wait for reply. And they changed this a little bit too. So wait for them to reply. Okay. So I'm gonna go contact reply. Add condition. They've changed this a little bit. Intent type is positive. Okay. And then let me see if what happens if I do this. I don't need that. Okay, so if it's positive, and we're going to test this, so don't worry. I'm also going to name it. So if they reply, and the intent is positive, right? So if I get like, go away, whatever, I hate you. Please don't do that to me. Then they won't get it. But if they do, if they're interested, then be like, great. You can register here. I will draw names November 6th. And then you can put like a trigger link, which is cool. Or you can just put the link. Okay, and again, you can test it. I'm also going to do a little bit of a wait here. It's always good to do like 1 or 2 minutes just so it doesn't flag you. Okay, so now we have a simple little workflow where I'm sending an email. Okay, one email, one text, and then I'm waiting for them to respond positively. And if they do, I'm waiting a minute and then I'm sending them the link. Okay. So what we're going to do is now we're going to test it. Okay. So testing it is pretty easy. You're just going to go up here to test workflow and then you're going to find your contact. Then you're going to click on run test. Okay, and then you should be able to make sure that you save it because sometimes you have to refresh to get the little man to show up. We'll see if he shows up here. Okay, cool. So it says that it emailed and it texted me. Now let's go to history. And why did it skip? This is always the fun part, is like trying to figure out why it wouldn't have gone through. Oh, I picked a contact that didn't have a phone number. Whoops. Okay. That's weird. But it says that it emailed me. So let me check my email. Okay, cool. So it looks like I got the email, which is awesome. Okay, so I found a contact that had my phone number and I got the text, so I'm gonna say yes. And then I'm gonna wait and see if I get the response. So I'm gonna refresh this because I did respond. So if I did it right, cool. You should see me here. Now I'm gonna get the text in a minute, which is cool. So my workflow works. And now I can send it to people. So what I'm gonna do is make sure that you turn it on and that you save it. And that's like the number one pitfall that I see people falling into is they forget to turn it on. They're like, why doesn't my workflow work? So please turn on your workflow, okay? Now, the easy fun part is you can go into your contacts in your smart list, and you're gonna wanna make sure that you have a phone number. The phone number is not empty, and that the email is also not empty. Okay. Now, this is and, not or. So I don't want to send it to anyone who doesn't have both. Now, if I wanted to do this, I could just send it to people who don't have an empty phone number, or I could do the email by itself. So the email. Okay, so then if the phone number is empty, it just will skip them, okay? So my email list, so what I'm gonna do is, you can actually save this as a smart list, which I have videos on how to do that, and then you can just access it later up here, which is cool. So I want to, do I not have an email list? Okay. So I'm going to save this as my email list. Smart list. And then I'm going to select everybody. Wow. This is growing fast. I love you all. Okay. So then add to campaign and workflow. Okay. And then here we go. So all I have to do now is find my campaign right here. And then I can add them all at once. I can schedule them, or I can add them in a drip mode. And then I click add to campaign workflow and bombs away. So I hope that helps you guys to create a workflow from scratch with positive intent and conditions. And don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me. And if you want more workflow videos, make sure to check out my other videos because I have lots of those. All right, I'll talk to you guys soon.